All right, and we're back. Technical issues have been fixed, and so we're gonna go right back into the game. Nano, your turn. We fixed some stuff, but asphyxiation is becoming an issue. So if there's something you're able to do about that, that would be super awesome.
Okay, so where do I go to fix asphyxiation?
This room right here.
The oxygen tank room.
Yeah, the oxygen room. Oxygen pump room. Which is currently partially flooded. And also, to get there, you have to go through room number 5, which is completely flooded. Oh!
That's fine.
I'm wondering if he wants to go through the room on fire to get there.
Well, the thing is that...
He can't unless he drinks.
He would have to drink grog to go in there. Or he could go in here and then still open this hatch. And water's still going to flow, right?
Would it?
I think so, yeah.
I think it just goes from... Yeah, probably.
Because it doesn't make sense that it wouldn't.
It'll just take an extra turn to open that again.
Like an extra minute, yeah. But also, it's going to take more time for you to move through water is the only issue.
It'll probably be better just to do that and then the two people that are already right there.
So you could possibly, let's take a look. So we need to get in there, but we also need to get the water out of there. So it might be a good idea for you to move into there and then pump the water out.
So what you want me to do is, what your suggestion is that I go into room 5 and then open the hatch between 5 and 8.
Yes.
So that all right, I am willing to do that. So what do I need for that?
All right, you don't need to do anything. Let me just look at the movement phase.
Okay.
Reflow water. Let's see.
I would guess that as soon as I open the door between here, I would get a face full of water.
Yeah, basically you flip that token over, and then you add a low water token to your room. Let's see. It doesn't.
This is going downhill fast.
It doesn't say anything about if you open a room with low water.
I don't think the low water flows into another room for low water, because then it wouldn't really make sense if you empty out a low water room and then open the door and it gets filled up again.
Yeah, so actually opening this hatch won't make any sense. Yeah. So we can just leave it on fire, I guess.
Just let it burn.
Because, I mean, there's so much water around it that if the fire spreads, it can only spread to 2 rooms.
Yeah,
so realistically. It's not that bad yet.
Like, I was thinking about it as this. Not that bad, maybe. I mean, I'm sure it's fine.
Yeah, pretty much. Okay, well, what's done is done.
The higher your voice goes as you're talking about it, the less confident I am about it.
Well, either way, you opened a hatch, so I moved your ghost tracker 1 minute.
We could pump the water out if we wanted to.
Yeah, you can do that.
I feel, though, if you wanted to pump it out, the best place to pump it out is here. Because that
all
is...
Right, so it's open. So, I've just been splashed by water, so that's going to take time, just readjusting that.
No, it doesn't...
That would take 2 rooms, or 2 minutes, and then to get to the other one, it would take another 2 minutes.
No, 1 minute.
No, because now that the water's there, it adds additional minute.
Yeah, but normally... Oh, you mean... Okay, so there was 1 minute to open a hatch, and then 1 minute to move through the water is basically what it is.
Yeah, basically, yeah. And it'll take 2 minutes to go through the next door.
So it'll be a total of 4 minutes from where you started to get to room 2, which is not that bad.
Yeah. All right.
So that puts you in room 2, in the oxygen tank room. So you can move your little doodad in there. Well, I'll move it for you.
My toolbox.
Okay, that's good. Gives you plus 3 to your skill on this.
And I would like to spend 5 minutes to try to repair the oxygen tank.
That's pretty solid. So that would move this down to here, which is both an event and an item.
Well, that's an intense square. And so you have to roll a 8 or lower.
Did you just draw an item? Because you're not there yet. I'm just going to...
Oh.
Just put down the grog for now.
Just put it down, Nano. You don't need to keep it.
Yeah, you might want to roll. Yeah, just roll first. Yeah.
Welcome back, Destiny.
And you are good.
Oh, just my gosh. That's oh.
So that has been... You can put that down.
You can put asphyxiation all the way back to 0.
And I'm then, just. I
oh,
take
wait a minute.
The,
wait
take
a minute, though.
Those guys, it's wait. Good. It's good.
It takes an extra 2 minutes because. Because it's partially flooded. So it's all actually right. here. That's okay, though. You spent 5 minutes, but it really took you 7 minutes.
It's alright.
Yeah, that's right. Forgot about
just
that.
Just trying to deal with all this water splashing about.
Yeah, it's really
the
distracting.
The heat, the water, the pressure. It's
it
all,
doesn't make
it's
sense.
All
why am I
toll.
Hot? There's cold water.
Okay, so now you need to update. So you move yourself down. So the next place you want to go is here. And draw an event.
Don't kill us.
You'll okay, be okay.
Oh, I saw that for a second.
Friendly fire.
A fire starts in a random room. A random room is flooded to high water. Random hand limit is 4. Dan
wow.
and Nano, you're going to need to discard
Dude.
Some stuff. Good thing.
You just ruined us.
So first discard down to 4 tiles, everybody.
We're just sitting here just like, yeah, this is with our 2 and 3 cards in hand.
Yeah.
Lovely weather we're having.
Discard to how many?
4.
4.
Okay, ready.
Okay. So you just want to put these over here. Alright, so now I need you to roll the dice, Nano. Right here.
You have to roll it twice.
Yeah. I'm going to start with 1 and do the other.
Which one do you want to start with? Fire?
Yeah. 10.
Fire and 10.
Oh, you just dealt with that.
And now we'll do flood.
Come on, 10. 10 or 8 would be great. So go ahead and roll it again.
Wow, you had to rhyme, didn't you?
Yes.
And 3. Boom. Great, the only one other place that...
All right, so that's that event. Next place you want to move your...
Next event.
Right here. So move your yellow dude here. And,
I'd like to think what's happening is that as I was in there, just, like, trying to deal with it and just trying everything, I'm like, okay, the pressure's done. And then as soon as I walk out, things are burning and things are flooding. And I'm like, you know, that Mary Poppins scene of...
Yeah, exactly. Alrighty, you get to draw another event. Come on, pressure track by 1.
Yeah, you're just ruining everything.
That's this game.
It's on my phone.
And right here? Well, you want to wait before you... Well, it's okay. Move here, and then... You want to move first, and then draw the thing. Just make sure. The active player discards down to 1 item tile, but then you also get to draw 1. So what happens first?
Oh, yeah.
It looks like
it
you...
It looks like the event happens first.
Well, I don't know. I would say left to right. Well, but you are moving that way around the board. I would say event happens first, and then you get an item. So you
I
get
would
to
agree.
Discard down to 1 tile, and then you get to add this grog back to your hand. Unfortunately, since you know it's grog, you know you can safely discard grog.
I'm going to hold on to the power reactor book.
Okay.
Manual.
Then I'm gonna steal these and discard them. And then you want to put those both in your hand. No, that you can keep. that you keep, because now you're drawing that. Oh, this game, right?
Yes, I chose to hold on to my beer, I chose to hold on to my vodka and the reactor.
It's okay, guys, I'll just stay in this place and keep repairing it.
So, Dan, can you fix some shit, please?
I would love to.
Maybe? Hopefully. This is getting it.
Yeah, this is getting a little out of hand.
I can go try to put out the fire.
Okay. I like putting out fires.
So it'd be 1, 2, 3, 4 to get in there.
If you drink grog.
Or have a fire extinguisher.
Well, one second. Because
the fire extinguisher you just have to have. You don't have to use it.
When a hatch is open, water may reflow. Enter room. It's only entering a room that takes an additional... It wouldn't be 3-4 to enter the room on fire. Because it's only moving through rooms that are... Entering a room that has water in it, basically.
So it'd be 2... So it'd be 3.
Yeah, it would be 3 to get there.
And then you can go put out the fires.
And then I will do 7 plus 3 is an automatic success.
So that puts your ghost tracker here.
So as yes. long as long as no one adds pressure, I'll be able to put out the pressure.
It'll be fine. Well, it's my turn next. Pressure. I might just come deal with that.
Well, you'll have to go through.
No, I can go through the other hatch.
It'll take more turns that way.
It'll take the same amount of turns.
No, I guess it would. Well, might as well get rid of the flooded.
I don't know. I like having the power... I like having the reactor room not flooded, to be honest.
Okay.
Whatever you say. Okay.
Alright, all players must play grog if possible. Increase intoxication.
I don't have any grog.
I don't have any grog.
I don't have any grog.
All right, and Nano, increase your intoxication by 1.
This one guy is just getting so drunk. Trying to just get himself drunk. Oh, look, a fire again.
Okay.
Okay, most of the ship is underwater.
I know, most of the ship is flooded.
It's the same room that's already on fire.
All right, nothing happens, I'm pretty sure. Let's see. I'm trying to find fire. Oh, let's see. The asphyxiation track still increases, but no new fire breaks out.
You had to look.
Of course! We're playing by the rules. And then that's also an event. Yeah. Timed event! Place the crush destruction token at 10+. Here? Okay.
Yep.
I might do that instead of fixing the pressure.
Yeah, I got the pressure. The pressure is...
Okay. So let's see. 2, 4. I can get there in 4 minutes. So let's do that. It's going to take 2 minutes to even attempt this. So let's plan for that. I've got my trusty book of mechanical shit. And I'm going to spend 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I don't even have to roll. We are not going to be crushed.
Also, the plus 2,
yay,
though, because...
Not being turned into
you have to move ahead, too, because of the water.
I already did. I did that at the start.
Oh, right.
Yep.
I'm on top of it. Heat track by one.
It's getting hot in here again.
Eh, just get in one of the flooded rooms. It'll be fine.
Sorry.
Four.
Why not just block the flooded one if you don't want four to be flooded anyways?
Well, because it could get set on fire. Yeah, let's just do this. That's fine. It's whatever.
Whatever.
Cool. At least there's nothing important in that room.
Alright. Oh, another...
Stop blocking all the hatches. We need those.
It's fine.
Oh, yeah. Block the hatch here. Ugh.
It's fine. We'll just keep that flood water right in there.
That flood water is staying there.
Yeah, I was like, no, we can't get flooded. And I get to draw an item. Oh, I can use that. And then here. Increase all low water tokens to high water.
Oh, great. I'm going to drown now.
Just pump the water and it'll be fine.
You're killing us all.
I just saved us from being crushed. And I don't understand why you're not thanking me.
You know, after saving us from being crushed, you started to drown us.
And then and the oxygen's running out.
Now the question...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right. I think now it would be appropriate to say, this is going downhill fast.
It's fine. Wait, oh, there you
I'm
are.
I'm pretty sure if we're in this room for too, if we're underwater for too long, we will die.
Yeah, basically, let's look at high water.
We are dead. We're just
we're not dead, dude. Just we're chill. Dead. Just chill. The thing is that you're not dead because you're not unconscious. So there's still a chance. Let's see. So how can we deal with this? I know you're gonna have to pump the water.
I wanted to fix our freaking pressure.
Oh, the only action possible in a room at high water is no action. A gnome stuck in a room at high water during his action will die this turn. But you can still move. So as long as we're not blocked in, we're fine.
No, because the other rooms are flooded.
Yeah, but you can still move through them, can't you, or no?
No, he's no action.
Movement isn't an action.
I'm glad nobody has become unhinged by the pressure and the stress and started to attack each other.
Oh, I would attack her, but I'm underwater drowning here.
Hey! It's not my fault. I was just ignoring all the bad stuff. So we wouldn't get crushed, okay?
Thanks.
I don't know as if you can move a room. If a room is at high water, it's not possible to enter the room at all. So, yeah, we're trapped in here.
We're stuck. We're dead. I'm dead. I can't
push it. So, at this time, do you want to use the less deadly die?
Do you have an aqualung?
No.
Okay, you're dead.
My aqualung.
Not you. I was asking Natty because it's his turn. He's going to die.
Thanks.
Well, that was just the worst.
It's fine.
The only person who's not gonna die right now is Dan, pretty much. Because Nano could go into
Nano
a
can
four.
Go into
Nano
true.
Can go into four.
No, me and you are dead, though.
No, I can actually get out. If Nano goes into four, I can go into two.
Oh, yeah, no, you just killed me. That's fine.
You're not salty at all.
No. Well, we are in the ocean.
In Soviet submarine, or submarine kill you.
Okay, so you take no action and you die. You discard all of your item cards and you remove your little timekeeper from play.
Welcome to Sunday's game night.
If you want, you could still play, but you would be playing a new gnome. That would start at the same location, I think, just with no items.
No, a randomly rolled location, but I think the game is close enough to being over that playing with gnome death is very interesting.
It's fine.
Yeah, you can just put it in your hand, because then we can't see it.
Okay, I'm not letting you see it.
Yeah, because you're dead.
Get out of here.
Okay, Nano, it's your turn. You're drowning in the oxygen pumps. What do you do?
I'm wondering, should I head to the power room?
That's the only place you can go.
That's the only thing you can do. You can only move to the room.
Okay, so that
takes one. Actually, it takes two. Because moving in there will... Because, yeah, it's... lightly flooded or whatever.
So basically, just gasping for air. I don't know what that's like.
While you're in there, okay. So here's the issue, though. Here's the issue, is that rather than going in there, you could actually stay in here. And do this asphyxiated event instead, which is probably the better idea.
You want me to die?
No, because you're not going to die.
It's getting really dark. It's okay for somebody else to die, but I don't want to die.
You are just as likely to die in 4 as you are in 2, is the thing. But if all of our turn trackers pass this... time destruction thing that happens and we all die. So I'm trying to prevent us from dying. And there's nothing you can really do in 4. You're better to all of us if you stay in 2.
Better to all of us if you try to save them, you know.
What are you doing? You still want to open the door.
I was going to try to die to save us.
Okay, so here's the thing.
You don't need to kill yourself.
You still open the hatch, you just don't move.
Oh, okay.
So that's why I was saying you're not going to die. You open the hatch to reflow the water. Everything reaches low water. And then you can do the asphyxiated event.
Okay, so...
So to do that, I think it's the same as the repair oxygen tanks action. It'll just take you an extra 2 minutes because it's partially flooded.
Alright.
Do you have anything useful in your hand to help with this?
No, I don't. I only have the reactor repair manual.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You could spend all 10 minutes on it, plus 2, and that would take you right before it. You would get out of it with 1 minute to spare. But you would do it successfully.
So how many events would I trigger? I think I'll trigger at least 4.
4, yeah, that would be 4. Or you could do 9 minutes, and then you'd only trigger 3.
Okay, I'll do 9 minutes. Okay. I don't want to trigger 4 events. 9.
Okay, then you gotta roll the dice and get a 9 or less.
On dice god.
Please.
Watch me get it.
Yeah, don't do it. Don't do it, Nano. 3. Okay, we're not asphyxiated. This is good. Okay, now you just gotta catch up with your ghost time tracker.
Okay, so what?
One of these.
Active player.
You only have one. You're fine. You stumble. It doesn't matter. You stub your toe in the water. You're like, oh, good thing I still have this thing.
A fire starts.
Don't roll, whatever that is that you got. 6, 8, 9, and 10. Don't roll any of those, and we're good. One.
Seven.
It does. That's a one, isn't it?
A one.
One.
Yeah. It wouldn't have mattered either way. I think, yeah, they're both flooded. Nothing happens. We don't even get the asphyxiation from it.
So does the flooding lower or
nope.
What?
Nothing happens. All right,
oh, don't forget to move your token.
Another random fire.
All right, roll again. I moved you up. Wait.
Okay, thank
you.
He should be on the third one because he stumbled the first time.
Oh.
Stumbled and fire.
Okay. 10. It's already on fire, so we increase asphyxiation by 1. Oh, wait, before you flip it, draw your item.
Okay, I didn't see what it was.
Yes. Yeah. At 20, you get to draw an item. And then you move up to here. And then you can flip your event. The order is very important to this.
Advance heat track by 1.
Alrighty. And then you advance all the way to here. And then we move the ghost tracker onto Dan.
Alright.
Someone needs to go and get some more items.
So Dan is going to open the hatch.
Boop.
And fight his way through to the oxygen room.
So that would be a total of 4 minutes that it would take.
So
you basically get in there right as I'm fixing this crushed event thing.
Just before the water rises. If you open a hatch into
nothing
low
happens.
Water, then it just stays blocked. Like, yours will go down, but,
nope.
But this will be fine?
No, I don't think that happens. I don't think it goes down.
Okay, then I am going to use a pump.
If you do that... Oh, I see what you're doing then.
Yeah, then the flood, the water will get out completely, then you can open it. And
yeah, okay.
And then you can live.
Yeah, I mean, I was going to live anyway, because I could still open the hatch on my turn and get out, because it wasn't flooded.
No. Right, no. Okay, so I don't have to do that. You can still open that water, and your token will go down.
Yeah, I can still do movement actions, and this flood will not increase, I don't think. Let me double-check that to make sure I'm not going to die. reflow water. Yeah, the only time water flows is that if there's a high water token and no flood token. And then
awesome.
It becomes low water in both. So I can still move into number 2 on my turn.
All right, then I am going to do 6 minutes. Oh, wait, plus 2. So... Yeah, I'm going to do 6 minutes plus 2 to fix the asphyxiation.
Okay, so you want to move your ghost token here?
I think it's there.
Okay, so you were on mine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep, I miscounted. So yeah, right here. Okay. So that just gets fixed because you have the manual.
And I get to play catch up.
The best part of the game. Nothing happens. A fire starts in a room next to one on fire. So I think for this one, you have to pick a valid room. And I think the only... Wait, why is... Okay, so the only valid room is 9, but it's blocked, so we have to look up to see if that is still valid. Where does it say? Fire events, okay. See, yep, you can, it spreads to that room. So it has to spread to 9. We move the asphyxiation up by 1.
Another hatch block.
Oh, please don't roll 1. Okay, well, 3 is completely blocked off now. Get an item. Don't block one. Okay, the only room, well, it could be 6, 9, or 10 would do something. Nothing happens. And then one more event, right?
Good thing with a bunch of water.
Hand limit is 4, and we're all at 4, so it's good. Well, or less.
Yep, yeah, so we're all good.
I'm at nothing. For no particular reason.
Bald is he's at 4.
Still a little sad. You couldn't tell.
Well, you were going to abandon us anyway, so.
Whoa. I was kidding. I would never, because I died.
So I am going to open the hatch and leave the room. I can finally breathe. This is good.
Good job surviving there.
Wow.
There's absolutely no salt there.
I am going to spend some time pumping the water, and there's no increased time for it being.
I'm not tormenting the cat. Tormenting
me. There is no increased time for it being partially flooded. So, let's see. You know what? I'm just going to have a short turn. I'm just going to spend... Well, I'll spend 5 minutes. Failed. That's okay. I get to go again.
You guys had better not die. I don't want to die for no reason.
8 gets blocked. Whatever. No one needed that grog anyway, right? Nope. Item? Ooh, interesting. Alright. And then I go to here. Another event. Another hatch. Ooh, wait, what are
we? I wonder what the number at the bottom means. Does it mean anything?
I don't know.
Yeah, that's for something else. I can't exactly remember what it was, but it was for something else.
Oh, that's for the intoxication check.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Yeah, that's right. 5. What do I want to block?
Am I having the need to do intoxication checks? Because I haven't been doing them.
Oh, yeah, you're supposed to do an intoxication check. I forgot. Because I forgot you're drunk. Well, we'll worry about that on your next turn.
I shouldn't have reminded you, because now I'm just complicating things.
Yeah, a little. It's
that was
okay.
Your own fault.
All right, it's my turn again.
Like, you know, I'm sure people hate that person. Like, aren't we supposed to be on fire, so shouldn't we take damage? And the boss is like, good point. And everyone just, like, stares daggers at you.
Let's see. I think I'm going to try pumping the water again. I'm going to spend 6 this time and hopefully roll better. 3! Yay! And then...
We've only got 10 minutes more until we're rescued. We can do this!
Heat track by 1.
Yay, I'm glad you guys are going to get rescued.
Don't worry, we will raise a glass to you, our fallen comrade.
Missile countdown.
At least have a nice funeral. Get my body and at least, you know, bury it so it's not out in sea.
That's interesting.
Or give it a Viking
Wait,
funeral.
It's from here.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, it's here. So that's gonna be hard to get to.
Good job, you just doomed yourself.
Maybe.
I shouldn't have opened my
you
mouth.
You have to put out the fire and then open that hatch.
So first we've got to unlock the hatch, then unflood the window, then open, try to do the code.
Maybe. A fire starts in a random room.
I shouldn't have opened my mouth.
It's fine. 6.
6.
Oh, it can actually start there. Of course it can. Alright. And then I get to draw an item. Okay. That's it for my turns. So, Nano, you're up. So, let's look up this
good thing, though. None of the things have gotten to the next reset point.
Oh, speaking of resets, you gotta put the Kraken in the deck. Flip this over and give it a shuffle. Okay, I also have to look up intoxication for Nano, because Nano is kind of intoxicated right now.
I'm sorry, guys.
It's okay. Okay, so it's after the action you have to do an intoxication check, I think. Yeah, faint check. Wait, no, you have to do that if you played a grog tile during your turn. And then the only way you can sober up is with coffee. So yeah, you don't have to be doing intoxication checks now. It's just if you play a grog, right, you're supposed to.
So, I was thinking of going to the item room and trying to grab some items.
It's not a bad idea.
Can I discard items?
You can give items to other people.
Who wants my reactor manual and my grog?
Giving items takes the turn 1 minute for the person who is giving the items. Like, only for the person who's in play right now.
Yeah. I think you should just keep them. Unless Dan All right. wants anything.
So, this is what I'm going to do. Open, unseal, or try to move. So, 1, and then 2, and
but
then any time needed.
That'd
plus
be 4.
Extra, yeah, that'd be 4, because you're moving into 2 flooded rooms.
Four. Now, I'm going to try to see if I can rummage anything up. Rummaging while flooded in double the time, too.
It should say on there, draw item tiles plus 2 minutes, 1 to 4 minutes plus 2 minutes because it's flooded. So it's 1 minute per tile that you draw, and then but it's also 2 minutes to even start doing that.
I don't think there's much point, because if I draw 2 items, the bomb will explode.
It won't explode until after we've all passed it.
Yeah, but he can't stop it. If he passes it, it won't let him stop it.
Yeah, that's true. But the thing is that you don't...
But he can clear the path for you guys.
Yeah, that's true. Nano, what are you trying to draw? Are you looking for anything particular?
Anything really that would help.
Okay.
Can we look into the... I would like to look into the deck and see if there's anything useful for our predicament.
Let's see. One, two, three, four. Like, even if you draw all four, that only puts you right here. It's not going to explode yet.
But it's 2 minutes per draw. Or 2 minutes per additional draw.
No, it's 2 minutes to do the action, and then 1 to 4 minutes per tile.
So it's 3 to 6.
Yeah, basically.
Oh, right.
Not.
I thought it was.
Not two to nine.
I thought it was
nine.
The water was cumulative.
It's just not... plus. Yeah. It's just plus 2 minutes overall.
All right.
So if you wanna, you can do as many as you like. Just make sure you. Let's see. You're doing the action, so that's 1, 2. And then you drew one. And then you can draw up to three more. I just have to look something up.
And I can't, and this is my action. I can't do any other actions.
That's correct.
So I guess I'd better stock up. Too much alcohol.
Stop drinking, then.
Okay, I can pick up one more. But so far, I've only gotten alcohol and pumps. What's this?
What is what?
I've got a book that is... Oh, this is... Active gnome gains +4 to fix the oxygen pump. So.
Oh, that's a pretty good book.
I guess that was kind of worth it.
So, how many did you draw then?
I drew 4.
Okay, so you should be. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here. Time to play catch up!
Okay, so, one.
A fire starts in a random room.
I was thinking, like, please don't be the kraken. All right, so I'm going to roll it.
Okay. 2, 6, 10, and 9 are bad. 3, nothing happens. Hatch. Uh-oh. So roll the dice.
Or hatch?
Yeah. It's a random room. Three. It's already blocked, so you can't do it. Nothing happens. Okay, so... That was that one. Then you did that one. So now you're here. Okay. Go ahead.
Wouldn't this be a draw block item? That's a hatch, too.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Then... Yeah, that's to go outside. Cause the top is a hatch, and those two are.
Oh, I didn't realize that you could block those. Okay. So first you do the event, and then you draw the item. Matt.
All right. Advanced pressure by 1.
New normal. I don't think that's going to be what kills us.
Look what you did! You killed us all! I'm just a ghost.
It reminds me of when we were all ghosts in Secret Hitler. How we were like, we are just telling you our things. Ooh. Okay. Do I need to draw another one?
Yes. Just one more for here. Hatch.
Locked hatch.
Five. There's really no good place to put it.
Up 6. Block 6 off. Probably be the best place to put it.
I guess.
Yeah. I mean, do we need... I mean, we wouldn't be able to go outside then.
Well, you have to go outside if you have to fight the kraken, is the thing.
Well, you still got 9.
Oh, I don't think the kraken's going to be what kills us.
All right.
No, I don't think it's going to be the kraken either.
All right, and then you move up to here, and that ends your turn. Dan.
All right, this is not looking like a healthy sub anymore.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. When I died, it was looking pretty bad, and it's just gotten worse from there.
Ugh, I really wish that hatch hadn't gotten blocked.
Yeah, that kind of blocked you there.
Well, you could unblock it.
Well, yeah, but for what I'm thinking, I have to unblock 2 hatches.
You could unblock 2 hatches if you don't spend a lot of time and get really lucky.
What are the 2 hatches you want to unblock?
Because I could also unblock a hatch on my turn.
Well, yeah.
Oh.
I'm thinking more of being the bad guy.
The thing is, we could be bad guys together. But the thing is, you can't abandon everyone until you hit this point.
Right.
Are you kidding? There's an actual mechanical thing that you can abandon people?
Yeah.
You have an aqua lung.
Which I do.
As do I.
Oh my gosh.
You're both gonna ditch him.
That was my plan. I was gonna run to 6, put out the fire, and just peace out.
I knew once you freaked out when they said to put it on 6, what you were doing.
I mean, here's the thing about playing board games with me. I always end up being the bad guy.
Alright, so I'm gonna spend.
I thought you were my friend. Survival. I trusted you!
As you burn and drown on the sub at the same time.
you see him like through the window. What? As you're swimming away.
Mm-hmm. I'm just pressed up to the glass. And it's
why'd you move me?
Oops, sorry, I moved me.
He moved the wrong token.
Alright, so I'm gonna crowbar and try to remove this hatch. I need anything but a 10.
Get a 10. Dang it.
Alright, that's all you can do. So, update. Don't block
Missions
me in.
Log.
Don't block me in. Alright.
It all turned bad. It just
9. Asphyxiation goes up by 1.
I'm sorry, Nano. You're gonna die. they're just gonna ditch you. Don't worry.
Oh no, he might.
No.
The thing is, he might lock
Don't
me in
lock
depending
me
on
in.
What he.
Okay.
No, nothing can happen.
Wait, what was the...
It was, he rolled a 10, but there's no unblocked hatch, so...
Nothing can...
And nothing happens.
Can we have a moment of silence for the soon-to-die
We can have a moment of silence if Nano dies, yeah. But he might...
Oh,
if he...
Oh, well, no, it's fine. I didn't want one.
We'll have a moment of silence for whoever loses at the end. Because there's 2 teams
I lost
now.
At the beginning.
But the thing is, you can still win as a player if everybody wins. So, like, if Nano wins, you win. You're on Nano's team now because I'm.
if Nano wins and you guys both get out, you guys die.
Yeah, we lose.
Yes. That's not happening.
Nano, win this for us!
I'm doing my best!
I believe in you!
3. Spending my fire suppression thing. To get +3 on the roll.
Just put a bunch of bunkers around here.
That's what I'm thinking.
I need anything other than a 9 or a 10.
Oh, Nano, you can't do it. You can't. You physically can't do it. No, you guys can't do it. You all lost.
The thing,
not all of us. Not yet.
No, not all of you.
Not all. The thing is like,
there's
I don't die
survivor.
Yet.
There's only one survivor.
Because the thing is that either someone has to defuse the missiles. Oh, I guess, or
it's
you get
impossible.
Out. I shouldn't have spent that much time. I should have stopped right here. Oh, well. I just let you win, Dan. Good job. Unless, wait. There's still a way.
Oh, yeah.
There's still
a
way for me to screw you.
Oh, crap.
Advance the pressure track by 2. We still might all die.
Stay here.
You still might all die. Nothing happens.
And then there is a thing on there.
One more.
Yeah, so let's put that there. Timed event doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter at all. Well, at least there's one survivor.
I timed that very badly.
Yeah, you really did.
All right.
So wait,
if they're
going
to
escape, then I can read. And so what's going to happen if they
oh
escape?
Oh my gosh, I didn't have an aqualung. I had a pump.
No, only... Oh. You didn't even have the right thing.
No, I didn't.
So
sorry, what were you asking, Nano?
So how exactly do I get rescued if both of you go past the missile's launch?
You have
no,
to...
You're not getting rescued.
No, the thing is, you have to get to the missiles, and you have to, I don't think it's possible for you to get in there.
No. It is impossible.
No, it's not. That's why I was asking.
No, you're dead. You're dead. Like, that's a guaranteed death. Right
so,
there.
Okay.
I died again.
So
I'm
you're...
sorry. I'm going to flip, and I'm going to try to escape with them.
No,
you have an aqualung?
No, I don't.
Oh, then it's, yeah. We're both dead, Nano. It's okay. Okay, so you started here, or where are you just completing all of your stuff now? Because you went out. Okay, so here. Go ahead.
Oh, nope, I already...
You did all of them?
I went out on 5.
Oh, okay. But do you not draw any more events?
I drew 1, and it was the heat plus 2.
Okay, but don't you draw more? Because it takes the
remaining time to do
that.
Oh, does it take the remaining time?
Yeah.
Yeah, it takes the remaining time.
So...
Wants to do services today.
Hatch blocked!
Oh, please block 6.
That would be really bad if the hatch
8.
That you just opened blocked. No! No! Do it for this one! Do it for this one! No!
Wow! No! Make it worse for him!
Oh no!
Sorry, Daniel! I couldn't
you
do
can
it.
Hear me banging through the door! Be like, no! Stop!
Oh, it's too bad you can't light it on fire, too.
That's so funny. Burn him!
I wasn't expecting...
I'll just run the missile to freedom, sure.
Yeah, I saw that. All right, Nano. All you have to do is get into the missile room.
He literally can't do anything.
I know. He's trapped. He could unblock a hatch, but that's it.
Well, goodbye, Nano.
And me.
Yeah, and you, whatever. Trying to dish everyone else. At least Nano stuck to it. At least he tried to save everyone.
You know, I think that's only because he didn't read the rules beforehand.
Watch this.
I think so also, though.
Who gave him the fine print?
What's me? Didn't try to abandon everybody?
So there's nothing you can really do except unblock a hatch, because you can't move into 7. You could open and close the hatch a bunch of times, I guess.
Just have fun while you do it, you know.
Like, just do something. What do you want to do, Nano?
I've got the pump action.
Oh, you can pump that
oh,
out.
Oh, that's true. Then... If you pump this out, but then you just have to sure you don't spend too much time on it. You can only spend 1 minute on it, is the thing.
No, it's not even going to work, because he takes a bit to open the door, and then he has to walk into the room. And then
he would have to do that next turn, though. He would walk in there and then die.
Yep.
pretty much what's going to happen is I'm going to walk in there and I like see this anime or like cartoon styled fuse kind of burning down, and then I see
exactly.
You know, the flash, and that's it.
Whoa, you get to see a flash? Whoa, at least you get to see a hero.
He looks out in the broken shell and sees me swimming away.
And I think you also, like, there's a scene of me, like, holding my pump as I'm banging on the hatch. Wow. Like, that's what this is,
right?
You
can't be in that room right now. Get out of that room.
Okay, so open the hatch.
No, you have to pump the water out first, and then you open that.
You can't do that, though. You'd have to pump the water out first, and then... That's the end
okay,
of your turn.
I'll pump the water first.
How much
okay,
time are you
so
spending?
What's gonna happen?
How much time are you spending?
I'm going to spend 2 minutes.
Okay, so you have
so
to roll.
I need to roll under 5.
I love how pointless this is.
It's futile. Hey, look, you got 5. You survived.
I mean, you successfully pumped the water out. All right, now we update.
You survived for a little bit longer.
Draw an event. Nano, draw an event.
All right.
Let's play it out.
Blocked hatch! I would laugh so hard if you blocked that hatch. Oh.
Please.
Don't get an 8.
Please get an 8. Oh, 6.
Okay. That would have been hilarious.
So do you want to lock me in?
Lock the top one. Make sure she can't escape.
I can't escape.
Make sure you're taking her with her. Make sure.
I can't escape. Look, these are my items. I don't have an off.
Yeah, well, make sure. Anyways, just do it. Just in case.
Oh, let me try.
Jeez, what an asshole.
1.
So I guess you have to block this one?
Well,
okay.
I mean...
Now I'm going to open the hatch.
You can't. Wait. No, you have to update. You have to finish updating first. Okay, you finished updating. Right. Now it's your turn.
Okay, so now I'm going to open the hatch.
All right, is that going to end your turn?
It probably will. So what's going to happen is I open the hatch and then I then see like the time. So what happens is I see like, you know, the LED screen like tick down as I open it and the water floods out. And then as soon as I see the dial, it's like 2, 1.
Oh, dude, look at the last action card you got. Look at the last action card before you die.
Yeah, let's see
somehow
it.
Somehow it saves you.
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens.
Boom.
And then boom.
Well, I'm dead again.
I'm really tempted to clip table.
I think that's the look on Nano's face when he opens the hatch.
You know, why don't you try to flip the table?
I didn't even make it.
Oh, you're too weak. Oh,
I'm too weak. I'm so weak.
You did that on purpose. You wanted us to fail against the table.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, the thing is, though, is that you haven't passed it, so technically the game hasn't ended. Once you pass it, the game has ended. So, like, basically, once you go in there to try to do that...
No, wouldn't it be at that time?
No, it says once all players have passed it. So basically, we are frozen at the minute of launching the missiles for all of time.
It's just paused at 1 second. And
shut up,
like,
Dan.
Well...
I wish I know know, I wish I had known I didn't have an aqua lung, and then I would have just tried to screw you over.
I had an aqua lung, and I discarded it like a stupid.
Yeah, like a stupid.
If I had known that was an option, I would have held on to the aqua lung.
I like how everyone's like, man, if only I could dead, like, long ago.
I dug through that item deck finding an aqua lung.
Yeah, I thought I had
first
one.
First eye to my Drew, the aqua lung.
Yeah, you know, this is why you gotta read the rules, Nano. Because I don't know what we're doing.
Okay, so you know what? I'm just going to... So, since I'm in there, and since we're not... I'm just going to stand there looking... I'm going to stand there watching the thing for, like, the next... The last minute. And just watching the seconds tick down. And...
Boom. We launched the missile. Flip the table! Alright, you know, you want me to flip the table?
Damn, that explosion.
Under the sea.
Under the sea. Everyone died. Well,
not everyone.
Dan.
It's over?
So, Dan, what are you going to say about your... What are you going to tell the rescuers or anyone that finds you about what happened here?
He was the only one there.
Anything I want.
We can't argue with him. We're dead.
I am zoomed in on your little Steam portrait. I'm just poking you in the eye.
I don't blame you.
Over and
jabbing
over.
Jabbing him in the eye.
You were a good companion cube opening the door for me.
I was. I thought I was going to follow you out. And then not only did I mess up my time on it, but I didn't even have an aqua lung. That's the funniest part.
I just love the image of the gnome picking up the pump, thinking that it's something else, being like, wait, no, this isn't how this works.
Like, trying to strap it onto his face, and then they're just like, it's just sucking air out of his lungs as it's trying to pump him.
Why isn't this working?
This isn't right.
This isn't how this works. This isn't how any of this works.
Oh, that was funny. So yeah, that was Red November. And everybody except for Dan died. And
Dan sacrificed us all for his own selfish ways.
I mean,
I went down nobly with the submarine.
I went down nobly, drowning.
I went down really unnobly, trying to break out with a pump.
All I wanted to do was fix that room again, and then I died.
Yeah. Yeah.
I just wanted you to fix the room once.
Oh.
I fixed it like 5 times.
You tried.
I mean, I fixed it like twice. All the other times, they all failed.
Yeah, it was bad rolls.
Let's not talk about that. That was in the past.
It was a fun game, though.
It was fun. I liked
Indeed.
It. It was a little complicated, so we had a bit of a rocky start. But, and we forgot that, when you drink grog, you gotta see if you faint. And that would have really changed the game, too. Because I bet we would have had a lot faster gnome death if you guys had passed out and then the flooding happened.
We had a rocky start and an explosive end.
At least
we didn't get killed by a kraken.
That's true. We didn't even get to see the kraken.
The kraken was just in the back.
Just watching everything
go down. Watching us get betrayed. Eating popcorn.
Eating underwater popcorn. And then maybe... Oh, you know what? Dad is the after movie snack. That's going to be my headcanon.
Is that I died after leaving?
Yeah, you got eaten by a kraken.
The kraken ate you.
You know what? I'm okay.
Yeah, we'll just say that so we're happy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like that. Yeah, like, yeah. I mean, that's not what happened, but okay.
I'll put up with it.
I'll let you guys humor yourselves.
You're dead, so I guess you can have that. Okay, moment of silence for the fallen gnomes. Moment's over. So
that was a solid game. I liked the pressure aspect. I liked the strategy behind moving and when your turn is going to come up again.
Yeah, I really like the use of time in this game. So a little bit about Red November. It is a fantasy flight game. fantasy flight games game, I guess I should say. If you go to their website, it's currently out of stock, but you may be able to find it either in your local game shop or eBay or some other online retailer. So you can look for it there. The mod for it on Tabletop Sims, pretty solid. It worked really well. It didn't have any glitching out on the cards or the tiles or anything, so that's pretty cool. Though, of course, I always say, if you like this game, if you can find it to purchase it, definitely get it. I think it's only like $20. It's either $20 or $30. It's 3 to 8 players, so you can play with like a lot of your friends, and it really changes the way the game plays based on how many people you have. So,
or you can be enjoying other people because you have no friends.
Yeah, or that.
Yeah.
So yeah.
If you're alone and unable to play it, just play it with your pets.
Well,
you can move for them.
It's cooperative, so technically you could just control 3 gnomes yourself and then betray yourself and then let yourself die.
And then beat the crap out of yourself and hate yourself.
Yes. So now we can...
That just turned really dark really fast.
I don't think I will ever actually forget the image that somebody just welding me shut in the room.
Just like, bye, Nano. You're like, no, bang me,
I'm just like,
bye.
I'm trying to get some items to help everybody, and then I just hear the door close behind me, and then someone like, wrenching something in there, and I'm like banging on it, going, no, no, stop, please,
help me.
All right, so just a reminder, there's not going to be a stream next Wednesday, or I guess this upcoming Wednesday. So if you want to catch my Dungeon World stream, it'll be the following Wednesday. Next week on Sunday is game night. We're actually playing Dan's Kickstarter game that he has on Kickstarter right now, Heir to the Throne. Dan, why don't you go and tell us a little bit about that?
Well, the Kickstarter's been going on for about 2 weeks now, and next week we're going to be playing Heir to the Throne. It is a 2-4 player card game where you are a fake noble house, and you're trying to make a great-great-grandson before your competitors and have him legitimized as the heir to the throne.
I actually got to play a playtest of that with Fool Inc., and it was a lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to seeing how it'll play with more people. And, of course, I liked it because I won. I beat him, and I always like to
always help.
I always like to win.
Typical.
I always like to win.
Really? Weird. Couldn't tell.
Yeah.
Trying to sacrifice all to the fishes?
Yeah, I tried, and then I really, really screwed it up.
Well, at least you got to watch me die in the same room as you.
That's true, but I didn't enjoy that.
Oh, okay. That makes me feel a little bit better.
I'm dropping a link to the Kickstarter in chat. I actually have to type it all out. Does anybody else have any projects or anything that they would like to promote now that we're at the end of the stream tonight?
No, I have no
idea. I would like to promote the kill the court martial Dan project that I'm going to be starting up.
Do go on. This intrigues me.
So what's going to happen? As a ghost from beyond the grave, I'm going to start haunting Dan, and or maybe just haunting the ship, and maybe escape from the ship. And once I'm above the sea, I'm going to start haunting people and anybody that I can invade or otherwise haunt stuff with. Up. I'm going to try to make them court-martial Dan or all the stuff for the horror that he subjugated people to. And even in memory of poor Astiani, who somehow attached a pump to her face.
Yeah, that's what my ghost looks like. It's, I'm just like, I have to haunt, like, I can only possess pumps now.
Yeah.
Now, wherever Dan walks, a pump, if there is any sort of pump nearby, it will just start squirting him.
It'll just start pumping him.
Yeah, it's like, it just starts, it, like, it springs on him, it tries to go for his face and just pump all the air out of his lungs, and he's just like, what is going on with this? Every time.
He can't go near
any of her ends.
He can't, like, go buy pumps or anything, like, he can never go near a pump again.
No,
it's gotten so bad.
It's never, traumatized
now. You can never
now.
Go to the gas station. You can never, like, use one of those. You can never use any sort of squirt bottle.
It's gotten so bad.
All right. So I think that's going to conclude it for us tonight. Like I said, we'll be back again at 10 p.m. Eastern next week with Heir to the Throne. Other than that, like I said, you can catch me not this Wednesday, but the following Wednesday for Dungeon World Old Town. We'll be starting episode 8 next week, and that starts at 5 p.m. Eastern. If you want to check out Dan's Kickstarter, you can find the link in chat, or you can just Google Kickstarter and Heir to the Throne, and you'll be able to find that there. Other than that, thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in. Thank you so much, all of you, for playing with me.
It was fun.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I had a lot
very
of fun.
Very much fun.
Bunkers aren't going to do anything.
Had lots of fun.
I really love board games, which is why I decided to stream
they're
board
great.
Games.
They're the best.
Yeah, I love
they're the
board
best.
Games.
They're games.
So just a quick shout out to both Grave or Highmail and Destiny for hanging out in chat. You can see Grave on some of previous Sunday is Game Night games. And he's not going to be back for Heir to the Throne, I don't think. But he'll be back again for later episodes, and that'll be fun. And then Destiny maybe will show up sometime. If she can stay up late enough. So that would be fun. So yeah, alright. We are out. Thanks again for tuning in. We'll see you next week for another great game on Sunday is Game Night.